I will talk about two projects of OMA, the Shenzhen Stock Exchange, which we delivered last year, and the CCTV building, which was delivered in 2013. I will also touch upon the TVCC building next to it, which we deliver in March next year. I will talk about the public meaning of these two buildings, not only related to the public accessibility of the buildings, but also the public perception of them. As said, I will take two different approaches. The Shenzhen Stock Exchange, I will mainly talk about the accessibility of a building that was, by brief, not accessible by anybody else than the Shenzhen Stock Exchange people, and how we worked to innovate that brief with the client to a building that takes a central position in Shenzhen, and which already did during building the building. And here you see a picture of a group marriage that took place on the roof while the construction was still ongoing. I'll also talk about CCTV. I will not explain the building. I will not try to explain the design too much, but I will mainly talk about the public perception during the design, during the construction, and now after for this building. And that perception has many elements, but especially the element of the observer, which I will try to highlight. Firstly, the Shenzhen Stock Exchange, creation of a new public space, as we called it. Shenzhen, 1980, nothing, was a fishing village, nothing more than about 3,000 people living there, very close to Hong Kong. And then, of course, there was the very famous saying, to get rich is glorious, which meant the Shenzhen economic zone, which meant a boom of urbanization that nowhere else in the world happened before. 2006, already 13 million people, currently 16 million people in a city, only 26 years later, 36 years later. The Shenzhen Stock Exchange was a competition where we were a substitute for another party, only 5 days before the deadline of the competition. So we had no time, and we had to go for a very bold statement in the design to convince the client of us being their architect. They asked us to design a tower, and they asked us to design a podium. And in that podium, they would house the stock exchange, and it would be not a public space. Everybody would be not allowed access to the plot. There should be a big fence around it, and only the people that live there or work there were allowed in. We thought that it would be better to innovate the typology of a stock exchange, also because it's not anymore a financial institution where the deals are actually made, but it is an institution now which is more about festivity, about listing, about kind of getting the recognition, and then everything else is in the electronic domain. So we lifted up that podium and created underneath the podium two plazas that are shielded from sun and rain, both very prominent in Shenzhen, and also to create a skyscraper typology that was very different than any of the others in Shenzhen. And this was an image that we presented during the competition presentation. The idea was to create a public realm below, to create a public realm inside the building that was accessible for everybody when the building was open, to see the listings, but also to see the museum elements of the building, and also to be able to use the conference center. And then a roof from where you could oversee the CBD, and which would become a public park where you could eat, drink, do sports, and enjoy the city of Shenzhen and its CBD. This is the building today. It's finished 7 years after the competition, and it's also fully in use at the moment. As I already said, the public plaza was one of the main key elements of our entry. We said we could create different plazas, one very public, which has also a shopping center and private elements, one related to the people that work in the building, that can have their breaks there and also can enter the building from there, and then a ceremonial entrance, which then was still requested with red carpet, etc. Now it's a little bit less extravaganza, but kind of to get into the building, to go up to the listing hall. The plaza was designed in such a way that it was one unity, but clearly expressed the different users. And in the top, we also had a park that relates to the building. Today, the situation is the same. The plazas are all there, and also the park is currently finished. The cantilever is 64 meters in one direction and 18 meters in the other. And what you see is that that cantilever frames the city around it from the plaza. So you can experience all the elements of the city while being there in a public space right in the heart of the CBD. Here another angle. And then here the park that was recently finished, was not finished yet when the building was finished, but recently finished, where there's a lot of green and also water. The whole base of the building is publicly accessible. In the core of the building, that is in between the elevator shafts, is the data center of the building itself. It's the only stock exchange in the world that has its own data center integrated, which sometimes is a difference of nanoseconds, which is, can be a difference of millions. And the rest of that plinth is fully publicly accessible, so you can just walk in and see what the stock exchange does. You see already here some effects of the facade. I will talk about that later. It's a very light building on purpose, so that we kept it very inviting. And then on top of that podium, we created a roof park. And that park is also publicly accessible through sky elevators from the lobby. It has some bars and restaurants which are not open yet. So if you go there now, it's still under construction of the of the people that will exploit these spaces. But it has also a small running track for the people that use the sports center in the base of the building. Here you see it's a paper cutting overlay over European carpet and a Chinese garden. This was the design in the competition. And this is the current situation where you see that the whole pattern is there, also the running track is there. Some of the pavilions are already installed and will soon be in use. So everybody can use also that roof of the building. Here from very high up, and you see the clear pattern. As I said, next to that roof, there's a sports center. There's some restaurants and cafes, also for the people using the building. So this is also where public and the users of the building will mingle. Here you see already the accessibility is already granted, so you can already go there. Then the public program inside of the building as an extension of this outside program. And that's in the podium. We created a space that has a convention center that can be used by the stock exchange, but also used by others, and the listing hall with all its museum facilities and exposition facilities. And from the from these areas, you can go through bridges to the tower itself. Again, a moment where public and staff can intermingle. Here you see people using these bridges over the lobby. And here you see how the layout of that floor is. The listing hall is not anymore this, which we know all from movies from Hollywood. It's not that anymore. It's a ceremonial space where they ring the bell, see the stock go up, hopefully, and then it's done. Everybody goes to have a glass of champagne, and the rest happens in smaller spaces these days behind computers. And next to it, the people that get listed get the possibility to expose their company, explain what they do, and why you should buy their shares. And here you see that at the moment, the bell is one of the only things that came from the old building into the new building. And at the back, you see the first museum or exhibition of a company that will be listed in about 2 weeks from now, when the first listing in this building will happen. Here you see there are tours through the building, and people can already use this space. So you can, if you visit the building, you can see it and you can go there. And then the convention center, which is already in use. There was an important international financial convention a few weeks ago, which has a large lecture hall, which can also be used as a theater. And it also has a large facility for meetings or conventions like this. From this, you're about 45 meter height. You overlook the city through the facade, because all the spaces are located through the facade, which is fully glazed. You have an overview over the city from there. On top of that are the people from the Shenzhen Stock Exchange. A large, very large floor plate, 3,500 people on one floor plate, working in the different departments that are always flexible. So sometimes they need more control people, sometimes they need more business development people, so they grow and shrink in the departments of the building, and that's also why it was so important to keep them all together. We did also the full interior for this building, the workplaces of the managers, the cubicles. It's not an archive at the back, that's a pull-out bed for the people to sleep inside of their cubicle. And then here, the end result of it. Everybody has access to the balconies or to the winter gardens so that they can also go outside. Also, the doors can fully open, so it's not always air conditioning. And here you see it in use today. On the top, there is a club and canteen for the users of the building, but you can also book events. So these group weddings can now not happen on the roof anymore, but can go all the way to this club and canteen, which can be used and again can be a mingle point. This was a design render. And here you see it today, where there is space for dinners, where there's space for events, and there's even a cinema on top of the building. Here you see it in use. This was for a movie on a Sunday afternoon. The facade, already said, we thought it was important to make this building public in many aspects, but also to make it therefore transparent so that you could see what really happens in there. So the whole skin of the building is glass. It's patterned glass, so it has regulation for the sun and the heat to come in. But everything you see is that same piece of glass in front of the structure, in between the structure, as the windows, all is the same. Here you see the mock-up that we did in the detail design stage. Here you see the detail, and here you see it today. A lot of people tell me that they think it's a steel cladding building, and that obviously was one of the things that we really tested. We really wanted to make it sometimes very opaque, and sometimes very transparent. Especially from a distance, it looks very opaque. And then when you come close, when you are in that public realm, it actually becomes fully transparent. Here you see an image from the neighboring building. You can look straight through it into the spaces. It also gave us the advantage to be able to integrate the lighting. So instead of beaming light to it, which in this case would immediately make a reference with the spaceship, to make it from the inside, behind that glass, and light up the building very subtly at night, including the full soffit, projecting light to the plazas so that people also at night can fully use it. The CCTV headquarters, slightly different angle to the public meaning of the CCTV headquarters. Quickly, a recap of the design. So we were asked to do two competitions at the same time, CCTV and the new Twin Towers in New York. At that time, OMA was about 45 people, so we didn't have the capacity to do both competitions, and we decided to go for CCTV because Remco has thought that the building would be finished earlier than the Twin Towers, and that it also would be more in the spotlight. We're not very sure if the spotlight thing is true, but it's very sure it was finished earlier. This was the master plan, a race for the height, so the highest buildings in the CBD in Beijing. That was the brief. Instead of going for that race of the highest, OMA thought of a different thing. We wanted to create a loop. And that loop was not just because of a nice shape. That loop was simply because TV making is a process that is a loop. It begins somewhere, It goes through the whole process, and then you start all over again. So pre-production, production, post-production, broadcasting, and then you go for the next, and the next, and the next. And that's also exactly how the program is organized in the building. So the whole process goes through that building at all time. And an advantage of that was that we could make that publicly visible if we bring a loop through the building where everybody, visitors, also the people that work there, can go through and experience all these different elements. That public loop is not open yet, but after TVCC, when that is finished, will open, hopefully mid next year. But already it is in a good shape, and I will show it you now. This was the model that we presented at the end of the competition, very similar to the building today, which looks like this. The public loop, it has elements that touch all the parts of the program. So all the elements of TV making in China can be seen, including part of the executive floor. So you can also see some of the executive people working. You come up in the central hall where the people of CCTV also go through from an escalator. You go next to the large studio where you can, in case of shows, be part of the show. Then you go through the actors' lounge, so you see how the actors and the people that make the TV take a break, get dressed, get makeup, etc., etc. And then you pass through the administration back house of the studio, just so you see how they film, how they cut, how they make the show. And then after that, you go up and you come in the overhang of the building where you can look down to the park or to the city. At this point, you're at 234 meter height. Not everybody dares to go on these windows, in my experience. And then you have also at that same level a cafe where you have a drink and where you can talk about the building or what you have seen. And then when you come down, you even go through the broadcast center. This is the brain of the building where I think 164 shows are broadcast at the same time to all the different stations they have. It's very hierarchical. This is only one side because the other side doesn't fit the picture, but it is exactly the same. So it's symmetrical on the other side of that round circle in the middle as well. That's one thing that is public to the building. You can access it. You can see how TV making in China works, and you can interact with it. Still, when I come to the West and I have to explain the building, a lot of people ask, can you really see it? Is it real what you see, or is it staged? It's real. And CCTV actually thought that our competition entry, because of this, was something that could bring their organization slightly further in the openness, which is interesting. I think the tour will go there, the tour to Beijing, and you will see, and you probably take that public loop, and you will see it. The building, of course, was part of public debate from the start. When it was announced that OMA won the building, REM came to CCTV and was interviewed on TV. And from that moment, there was discussion about the building, its form, its shape, but also its meaning for the city. The West really wanted it not being built. Almost every important newspaper in Europe and America had pieces that said it is stalled, or it will never happen, or it stops. Here you see a collection over the years between 2002 and 2007, when the building finally started to come up. People stopped this type of communication about the building and started becoming interested in its original idea. So there was from the beginning a lot of rejection of the design. At the same time, we were constantly meeting all kinds of specialists to show that a shape like this can be built and is technically possible. So we had meetings during the course of a year. I think Arab Chess is also here. I think we had more than 40 or 50 of these buildings that meetings that took a full day to get approved. We also built a small model of the building, 1 to 20. It was not that small because it was really big to make sure that it was earthquake proof. We also had to prove that. And then in the summer of 2005, it was finally the point that we could break ground. Rem Koolhaas, Ole Sheeran, the partner in charge at that time, who I think spoke here yesterday. Of course, a very happy moment. From the spring, the foundations were ready. The steel came up, and the debate of the building slightly changed. In the winter 2006, the connection of the two towers, it was calculated that that had happened, had to happen on one moment because of temperature and wind or whatever. I still don't fully believe it. But it was a ceremonial moment. This is a picture I took, which is a kind of an interesting thing. We were standing at the site. And then here, still at that moment of time when the building was coming up, still a lot of public debate and resistance. We were building for tyrants. We were stars, etc., which was an interesting debate to follow. But it also became, at the Olympics in Beijing, immediately an image that CCTV used to portray to the whole world. So it became also visible in another idea, not only by controversy. And this was, at that time, the state. It looked as if people were working there. It was not the case. There was nobody inside yet. But they used the light to portray that the building was finished. We were also in all kinds of comics, which showed that the people noticed the building. And then this happened in 2009, which obviously wasn't a good moment, not for the project, but also not for OMA. Luckily, it was not the CCTV building itself, but it was the TVCC building next to it. That was already finished. It would be delivered 2 weeks later, and the last things on the roof were still be done. But also this controversy we overcame. We stayed part of the project, and the project is currently rebuilt. And this is the current state. It is exactly the same design, exactly the same fit-out as it was before the fire. And we will open it in March 2014. Mandarin Oriental is still the hotel that is in it. So you can visit it when it's finished. You can stay there and also see the tower. And this is the combination of the two together as it was meant in the competition from the park that is not accessible yet, but again in March will open with the TVCC building so you can go there. The idea about the building has completely changed since. It's now part of the marketing of Beijing as one of the few modern buildings in the city. It is also part of all the architectural tours in the city and even became the image of many of these. You see the building back in all kinds of nice advertisement. Here, this is a paper in Hong Kong that I found one morning on my doorstep where there was a car with the building on top of it. It's never asked permission. It was interesting. And then even the BBC did a show, Top Gear, about Chinese cars, and they were driving underneath the building, which was also quite interesting for the use. And of course, November 2013, the CTBUH recognized the building as the best skyscraper for Asia, but also worldwide, which we are still very proud of. And now the building also turns into art. This is an image I photographed in North Korea. And that's what I wanted to say. Thank you very much.